One of the viewers is asking me whether microcontrast exists. Well, it's a term, it's a made-up term. Okay, some people call it contrast, and they mean exactly that. Some people call it acutance, others call it clarity, others call it tonal separation, the color tonal separation meaning. Let's first see a visual example. On the left we have bad microcontrast, and you see a lot of color aberrations here, and chromatic aberrations generally they kill tonal separation because they introduce secondary colors. For example, here we see a lot of purple and bluish and all that stuff. This is a little better, and on the right it is excellent. It's the right is a result of an apochromatic lens, precisely focused. Now, how would we define microcontrast so that we all speak the same language and person A means the same thing with person B? Let's give it a definition, and this definition may actually spread around because nobody else have come up with a linguistic definition of it. And since I'm the translator, the linguist, here is your definition. Microcontrast is the level of tonal separation, color accuracy, and acutance, but acutance is also called sharpness by many, in the in-focus area of the image. Well, that's obvious, in the in-focus area, because we cannot be talking about acutance in the bokeh area, right? In the out-of-focus areas. Again, the level of tonal separation, how the colors separate nicely from each other and they don't overlap or pollute each other, color accuracy and acutance in the in-focus areas of the image, which also results in better overall texture and a stronger visual impact. Okay, let's talk a little bit about this tonal separation. Now, theoretically, if this disc was not skin tones, but instead it was 255 tones of green and blue and red, and theoretically you should be able to see all these tones separated from each other clearly. Theoretically. Now, if you add in chromatic aberrations, obviously you're gonna see wrong color tones. So chromatic aberrations will not let you see the correct tones of colors. Therefore, they kill microcontrast. Got it? Alright. Now, because some will say, oh no, what are you talking about? I know a guy, at any rate, theoretically you should be able to achieve that. All the tones separate nicely if you use the best aperture of your lens and you have good lights and good white balance and everything, right? The problem though is not this today, because with good equipment you can achieve that. The problem today is color pollution, as I call it. The general tint of the image, the hue, the cast, the color cast. For example, in this image you will see, my daughter took it from the car, 70 miles an hour, and you will probably say, oh, this is a white building. Take a friend and go to the park and have him or her wear a white sweater and sit on the grass. You take the picture, you go back home, you sit on the computer, you say it's fine. You print it and then you see it's a little greenish. The white shirt that he's wearing, he or she is wearing, is a little greenish. It's white against dark, against a green background. You say, how did this happen? So you run back at the monitor and then you see it on the monitor too. That's why I'm telling you guys, print even one set only of pictures in your lifetime, just one, because you will see the wrong color on the print and then you will become aware of it on the monitor as well for the rest of your lives. You only need to print one. Now in this image you think this is white, but it's not white. In the beginning you thought it was white. It's greenish. So how do we fix it? I don't know, I'm not a Photoshop expert, so let's choose something different here, like standard. What was the color? It was okay. Let's choose an automatic white balance, the cloudy. Or let's pick up a white point somewhere. If we have a reliable white point, is this a reliable white point? Maybe. Is this a reliable? Maybe. Maybe it is, right? Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. That's the thing. So let's go with that. It's 6-2. It was a cloudy day, which is 6,500. Let's say 6,400 to satisfy everybody in the game. And now I'm going to go into the color module and remove some hue a little bit here, under saturate the greens. Maybe I could give a little more luminance on the greens to push them towards white, because luminance pushes the RGB values towards white, saturation pushes them towards black. That's the only thing that Photoshop does. It changes the RGB values of the pixels. It doesn't add light, doesn't remove light, just changes the RGB values of the pixels. That's what it does when you fix chromatic aberrations too. And just for illustrative purposes, I'm gonna add more white here to emphasize it, just to show you guys what's going on. So now we have before and after. Let's zoom in and see what before and after looks like. In the before picture, everything was greenish, including the grain containers. Now they look brown, which is more the realistic color. This has a greenish tint. Now it has a little bit of a reddish tint, so maybe we overdid it here. Now it looks a little better. You see, this line should not be green, should not be red. Okay, maybe it needs to be a little less exposed too. But you see here, the after is more realistic. So that is pretty much the problem that we're dealing with today. That even we have the best lens and the best aperture and all that and no chromatic aberrations, we're still going to be dealing with this hue and overall cast pollution, as I call it. In the case of chromatic aberrations, the problem is more severe, because you are destroying the different tonalities of colors, you're replacing them with secondary colors or mixture of colors. It's all a big mess. Also, another subject that I would like to touch with this. There is a method out there which is not a correct method, and they say that if you turn the image into black and white, it's going to show more tones and stuff. This is the image of the tree with a lot of chromatic aberrations. Unless you have seen ever in your life a tree that is purple and greenish and all those different and blue and all these colors in the trunk. Looks weird, right? Because the chromatic aberrations have destroyed also micro contrast, and it's not a clear image. Now, the only thing you can do with the saturation slider here is desaturate the same colors. So now I have desaturated blue, desaturated red, desaturated purple, and desaturated green. It's not black and white. Of course, there are more tonalities in it because there are desaturated chromatic aberrations. So they're going to show a lot more, being a lot of different gray tones. But all that I'm seeing is the gray tones of the chromatic aberrations. So this is totally, totally wrong. It's got nothing to do with micro contrast. All I'm seeing is the desaturated version of the chromatic aberrations. So this is totally wrong. So let's repeat that again, one more time, one last time. I'm going to mark this video by putting in the title definition, so we don't have to talk about it anymore. It's the level of tonal separation, color accuracy, and accutance in the in-focus area of the image. Thanks a lot. Bye.